We're going to say that Boyle's law, Charles' law, and Avogadro's law, each of the gas laws focuses on the effects that changes in one variable can have on the volume of a gas. So these three guys are looking to see the effects that all of these changes have on the volume of a container. We're going to say all together they combine to give us the ideal gas law. This equation is going to be essential for our calculations dealing with gases. So the ideal gas law is PV equals nRT. We're going to say that P here equals pressure in atmospheres. We're going to say V equals volume in liters. We're going to say that N equals our moles of the gas. T equals temperature in Kelvin. And here R equals our gas constant. So from the name gas constant, it means that it's a constant number. So it's going to be up to you guys to remember what that constant number is. So R equals 0.08206. And the units are liters times atmospheres over moles times K. And what you should realize is that the units in R are what telling us the other units for everyone else. So the units we find in R dictate the units found in all the other units. Because R has liters, volume has to be in liters. Because R has atmospheres, pressures in atmospheres, moles, and Kelvin, that's why temperature has to be in Kelvin. The units of R dictate the units of all the other variables.